Somebody ate the entire bag. This is like, there was only one bag of this.
I know.
And
I totally
ate the whole bag.
I slammed that bag.
Should have gotten two of these.
Yeah, you should have. Hey, what's up, family? I'm Rachel.
And I'm Joe.
And we are Two Crazy Ketos.
And if you're new to our channel, welcome. Here on Two Crazy Ketos, we do different things like recipe videos and we do product reviews. We talk about various keto topics. And then every Monday, we sit down on a couch for Keto on the Couch. We just kind of talk about what's going on in our lives for the week.
You can find us in different social media platforms like Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter.
And we have a website, which is twocrazyketos.com. And that's where you're going to find all of our different recipes. Now, we do upload at least 5 new videos every single week, so make sure you subscribe to our channel.
And don't forget to hit the little bell icon, and that way, every single time we have an entire bookcase full of meat, you'll be alerted to it.
So we did it. We went ahead and we tried carnivore crisps. I know it's been around for a while. People have been talking about it. I finally did get to taste them when we were in Omaha. So I started really investigating the company because I was looking at them, and when I first tried them or before I tried them, I thought it was just like beef jerky.
Yeah, that's
but what it's not like beef jerky. It's kind of hard to explain. But before we really decided to affiliate ourselves with them, I really wanted to investigate the company, see where it came from, what kind of ingredients. And once I saw it, I was shocked, and I decided that we were going to order every single flavor so that we could try them all.
Try it all.
Which I did. I ordered them all. Even some that I knew that Rachel wasn't going to really like.
Like organ meat.
So we ordered them all, and we're going to try a bunch of them here. We have not tried them all. We've only tried a couple of them. And there's a couple that we cannot try right now because we're in the middle of our beef, bacon, butter, and egg challenge.
We can't have elk.
We can't have chicken. I mean, we could have it here. It's not like we'd be eating a whole piece. It'd be a little taste. And
we're rule followers.
We really wanted to stick to the challenge. And Dr. Barry said no chicken. Again, it's a meat thing. It could have it. We could have it. It wouldn't derail us at all. But we really wanted to honor what we told Dr. Barry we were going to do.
Yeah.
So we're going to try all the beef ones today and the pork one.
That doesn't make me sad.
I'm really excited about this. Like I said, I really thought it was beef jerky, and it's not.
No, it's like the meat part is like a potato chip that's beef flavored, like awesome.
Right.
But the fatty parts stay good and fatty.
Yeah. And it's again, it's not beef jerky. It's not thin pieces of meat. You really just have to try it, and we'll try to show it to you.
Yeah.
So we've got several different flavors. We're going to try them all that we have here. Now, we actually had one, and somebody ate the entire bag.
I'm sorry.
I got literally one piece out of this.
I did not try them in Omaha. The first time I tried them is when Joe said, hey, want to try this, and put it in my mouth during a vlog.
So this is the scraps that's left of ribeye.
The baglings.
And what you can see, if I can get it to focus, so if it's not there, it's because I couldn't get it to focus. You can see that it's got a lot of fat on it. It's greasy right in my hand. I'm sure you're eating. Here's like literally a piece of fat that's probably staining the tablecloth. I mean, it's like melt in your mouth fattiness.
But the meat part without the fat is like a potato crunchy. Chip. Yeah.
Like you can use it for dipping. Okay, so we have four here. Mm-hmm. Beef brisket, pork loin,
eye round,
and beef top sirloin. And then, like I said, they also have ribeye. That's their beef line.
And beef
they
liver.
They also have beef liver, which Rachel doesn't like liver. And she's like, that's not bad, especially if you were like dipping it in something.
It is the best conveyance of liver that I have seen yet.
Because it doesn't have that livery taste or nastiness or anything about it.
I do like it with a little extra salt.
Yeah. Now, one thing that I liked about it, and we're jumping ahead to ingredients because we are going to do 5 things. They do use Redmond real salt, which is another reason I love them. For me, it could use more salt, but that's because I'm keto and everything for me is undersalted. I add salt to keto chow. If that lets you know where I'm going with that.
That puts it in perspective.
So for most people, it's probably perfect. For me, everything has to be extra salty, which is kind of funny that prior to keto, I hated salt. I didn't cook with salt. I never added salt to my food. And so now I need a lot of salt. So when I tell you it needs salt, that's just me. Where are we going to start? Let's start with sirloin.
Okay. I feel like that is where you would start with steak, right? We went right to the ribeye, which is my favorite.
That's why I went there. Plus, I only had one bag of that. So, okay. So here you go. So this is what I'm talking about. Look at that.
That is huge.
And you can even see the fat that's on there. And I mean, here's the thing. I want you to hear this. Do you hear that?
No, that's a snap.
I mean, that it's like literally a potato chip. I mean, I'll give it one more time. I mean, you don't get beef jerky like that.
You don't get beef jerky to make that kind of snap.
Okay.
And we've made our fair share of beef jerky.
Okay. So we're going to start off with just the meat.
Okay.
Give you that.
Thank you.
So good.
It's really good. You can tell they're using really good steak. This is not like past its prime. This is excellent meat to start with.
And here's a piece of fat. It's like eating a potato chip.
The fat stays nice and juicy,
mm-hmm.
right? It has that beautiful fatty flavor.
Okay, what's next?
Let's try the brisket. Because we just made one last night.
I know, I was saving that for last, but that's okay.
That's all right. How does it compare to actual brisket?
I want to see, can I tell a difference in the meat flavors, or should I just get one flavor? Ooh.
Totally looks like bacon.
See, this one isn't quite as crispy, but there's more fat in it, so you can see all the fat in there.
Oh my gosh, and it smells so good.
Oh, we didn't dink it.
Oh, dink.
Dink.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, that's my favorite so far.
Mmm.
That is packed with flavor.
And that's got a lot of good salt.
All the salt really gets in it because there's so much fat.
But that's how brisket is, isn't it? Right? You have to season brisket really, really well.
That is my favorite one.
That's my favorite one, and I didn't think I would like anything more than ribeye.
Okay.
Wow. I just want to be alone with this bag right now.
Well, guess what? Oh, man.
Oh, don't you hate it when you
no, I got it.
Miss it
okay.
on the Ziploc part?
Eye of round.
Look at that.
I'm trying to save it. I mean, you can break it right along the grain of the meat. Dink.
Dink. And it smells good.
That's my second favorite.
Mmm.
That is flavorful.
That is flavorful, and this would make a great chip for a dip.
Yep. That, wow. I don't know. That may even be, brisket's number one.
Because I feel like the brisket, with its fattiness, provides its own dip. Like the fat is like, fills it. But this would be great as like a nacho.
Yep. I got a secret one for you.
Okay. Do I want to know what this is?
Well, I want to see if you can guess what it is.
Okay.
There you go. Nice big piece.
I won't even look at it.
Wait. I got to get another piece out. I grabbed the small piece. I want
to
be fair.
I'm trying not to look.
Okay, dink.
Dink.
Wow.
I can tell it's beef,
mm-hmm.
but it's very subtle.
It's beef heart.
Nuh-uh.
Seriously, I did not tell her what I was giving her. I figured she figured wow. I was giving her the liver.
No, because I've already had the liver.
Right.
So I'm
That's
like,
the heart.
Wow. That is really good.
It is really good. Like, it does not taste like an organ meat at all. Like, we could definitely eat that whole bag.
Yeah, that does not taste like a tingy.
No.
You know, like where it gets like an irony flavor.
Okay.
Wow, that's good. I'm surprised.
You want to go pork loin? Pork loin.
Bring the pig in.
Now we can have this on the beef, butter, bacon, and egg challenge because we'd asked Dr. Barry and he said, when I say bacon, I can't get my fingers in there. He said, when I say bacon, you can have all pork so long as you're not adding any carbs to
I'm still getting used to fingernails. So like I can't open anything right now.
Give you that whole piece.
Okay. You can tell that it's pork. Oh, I thought you were gonna like.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
That's good too. It's like a potato chip. It's almost got a potato chip feel. Taste too. More salt though.
This reminds me of, we had tried a cracker that was like all meat, but it almost broke your teeth off. The flavor, I like the flavor, but the texture was terrible. And this is like nice and not gonna break my teeth off.
Okay, five things?
Mm-hmm.
Five things. So if you're new to our channel, we review all products based on five things. We're gonna talk about the ingredients. Does it keto based on a nutrition label? How does it taste? How much does it cost? And finally, would we recommend it? Number one, the ingredients. This one is really easy, okay?
Yeah.
Every one of them is the meat, water, and Redmond seasoned salt.
And that's it.
That's it. So we got the ribeye, grass-fed beef ribeye, purified water, Redmond sea salt. Even the liver, grass-fed beef liver, purified water, Redmond sea salt.
They said it couldn't be done.
I mean, and again, we got beef heart, water, purified water too, Redmond sea salt. Grass-fed top sirloin, purified water, Redmond sea salt. Jumping over to the pork loin, pork, which is pork loin, purified water, and Redmond sea salt. And then, of course, we do have chicken ones, which are on the back shelf. We will talk about them in a separate video
once we can
eat chicken and elk and lamb again.
Yeah.
So the ingredients are really good.
It doesn't get any cleaner. You just need somebody that knows how to prepare it to get this type of like flavor and consistency and the texture.
Yeah. Now there is a little bit of copy on the back. It says, born from need, nothing on the market that had crunch, health benefits, flavors of lean and sustainable protein without the additives that chips and other snacks are packed with. JoJo's Jerky, who is the producer of Carnivore Crisps, has been in the business for almost a decade, always being conscious of clean living and sustainability. From the drying meat trims into dog treats to rendering healing tallow from beef fat, and to the repurpose of every stage of potential waste that would come from a USDA plant.
Yeah.
Bottom line, this is the cleanest protein on the market. So make it your own and reach your peak performance. Because they also do make dog treats.
And as soon as we open a bag of this,
the dog comes running.
The animals congregate. Yep. I have a cat right here. We have a dog that we knew we just had to put away because they smell it. There's freshness about it.
So number two, does it keto based on a nutrition label? And I can give you the answer of this without even looking at it
because
there's only two ingredients, meat and salt, which
means water.
Well, that's not an ingredient, right? But that means that every one of them are going to be zero carb unless there is carbs in the actual meat. For example, liver, there is two carbs in a serving.
But that is natural.
That is natural. There is
carbs in liver.
Yep.
So, okay, so I'm just grabbing the closest one to me. The beef brisket is, a serving size. There's two servings in a container, which good luck because it's so tasty.
Yeah, maybe you can get two if you can retain yourself or restrain yourself.
Yeah. So, here comes Charity right here. All right, calories are 90 calories, 4.5 grams of fats, zero total carbohydrates, and 12 grams of protein. These are not for you, Charity. I get why you love them because it's actual. You don't see her getting up here if there's like a sugary snack.
Right. And then just to give you an idea, the pork, there's all of them have two servings, 70 calories, 2 grams of fat, 12 grams of protein, zero carbs. And they're all pretty much the same, about 12 grams of protein, just depending on which one it is, determines how much fat. So for example, the I Round has 4.5 grams of fat. So does the sirloin, whereas the pork only has 2 grams of fat. The beef liver has 2 grams of fat. So very, very, very clean ingredients and great macros.
Fun way to get your protein in.
Number three, how do they taste?
Delicious.
I think they taste really good. It tastes like good natural meat. There's no flavors hiding it from the meat. There's no teriyaki sauce or anything like that. I'm really impressed with the flavor, even the organ meats, which I am shocked that we like the organ meat. I can the beef liver, I can see us eating it just because if you can mix it in as a chip, that will be really good and a great way to get your liver in. But the heart, I could definitely see us buying the heart again, especially because of the price. So let's talk about number four. I've got the prices up here. The reason I say that is a bag of the beef liver is only $6.49.
Wow.
So, and the heart is $7.99, which is the cheapest things that they have. Obviously, it's the part of the cow that nobody wants.
But they should be eating it, though.
And again, it's very flavorful. So if you want to just go over the most expensive one, of course, is the ribeye. That's the one that Rachel ate the entire bag on us.
Sorry.
Then we have, that's $10.99 a bag. The top sirloin is $8.99 a bag. I'm sure if I can get up here, the eye of round is $8.99 a bag. And the brisket is $8.99 a bag.
Here's the thing though. We tried to go buy a ribeye steak yesterday.
Ooh, rogue piece.
Yesterday. It was $17.
In Aldi.
For a ribeye.
Just over a pound.
In Aldi. So this is less than actually buying a steak, and you're getting an entire steak in a bag.
Yeah. Now, people do ask, like, why is beef jerky and stuff like this so expensive? Because you got to realize that when you go buy that steak that is $13 a pound,
right,
they have to dry it. All the water comes out. So to make a pound of this, they need like a 4 to 5 pound steak.
Right.
So that's just something to remember. Then you have to go through the whole drying process and everything else. Mm-hmm. So, you know, when you get regular beef jerky, it's generally only like 25% of the original starting weight. So think about what this is, where you're really taking all of the water out.
Yeah.
If you're interested, the pork loin is $7.99.
That's a good deal.
The lamb, which again, we are not trying right now, it's a leg of lamb. It is $8.99. And then the elk,
just for fun,
which is out of stock right now, is $11.99. And that is free range elk. I'm really excited to try that one.
I am too. And like, how fun would that be to have company over and be like, hey, you want, you know, have a chip.
Yep.
You just ate elk. How cool is that?
So number five, would we recommend it?
Yes.
Absolutely. I'm glad I bought a whole bunch of it. I'm glad I bought three bags of the brisket. So there's a bag for you.
Thank you.
And then there's this bag and the other bag for me, since you ate the entire bag of ribeye.
Good luck.
Well, if I hide it, so.
I'm going to use Charity and Tabitha on my team to sniff it out.
I wonder if we could give Charity a piece of beef liver if she would eat this.
Let's see.
So absolutely would recommend this. I'm curious where you're gonna rank your favorites, like what would you order?
Definitely,
especially knowing the prices.
Definitely the brisket is, I'm all about it. But I'm gonna tell you something that's gonna surprise you. I would absolutely order the organ meat. Get the organ meat because that is going to be the easiest, cleanest way to get them. Yeah, she's not upset.
She's gonna go.
She's like, okay, where she's can like, I go?
Oh yeah, yeah.
And be alone with this.
Do you wanna know about the carnivore dog?
Yeah.
Okay, so they have the carnivore dog. They have bacon jerky, beef and liver sliders,
how
beef
cute.
Burgers, beef jerky treats, chicken jerky treats. They're all either $11.99 or the jerky treats and the bacon jerky are $12.99.
Our grand puppy
we should
getting these for in her stocking.
And yeah, again, two ingredients. Those are 5 ounce bags.
Here it says human graded dog treats.
So I could technically eat it.
You could absolutely eat it. Oh. That's a company that stands behind
the
product.
Did I see bacon? Can we get
bacon jerky
and eat it ourselves?
It says human grade.
Human grade dog treats. I wonder. Dried to perfection, applewood smoked bacon. Perfect treat for your best
friend.
Without
additives, colors, or fillers.
That is awesome. Now, we have after
You're
trying...
You're my best friend. It's perfect for him.
After trying this, we did decide to start an affiliation with Carnivore Chris. So there is a link down below, and that link will get you 10% off of your order, which we are really, really excited
I'm
about.
I'm super excited.
I will be ordering a whole bunch of this stuff. Again, I really think, for me, I'm going to probably stick to the brisket and the eye of round. I think the ribeye is really good, but the pieces are much smaller.
Mm-hmm.
And you're going to go through the bag a lot quicker, and it's more expensive. So I feel like I get more for my money and honestly more flavor out of the brisket and the eye of round.
How did you already work the brisket on your side?
Because I told you, you ate the entire bag of ribeye, so I should get the open bag of beef brisket.
It just totally moved that way. It just
totally shifted. Here, you can have this one.
I won't mind eating this, which is a big thing for me to say. If you've been watching the channel for any length of time, you know I don't do organ meat.
Charity is enjoying it right now. No, I know. Kidding. She's down there looking for more. She would like some more of that.
I know. She's going to get all of the tablings.
So, let us know down in the comment section, have you tried carnivore crisps? And if you have, what is your favorite flavor? Also, let us know about the dog treats. Like, I think we're going to order a bag. The problem with giving them to Tabitha is she's going to eat the entire thing in like one bite. But definitely for Jenny, we should get a bag for Jenny because Christmas is coming. You want more, don't you?
And we want to be the favorite grandparents. Absolutely. Obviously. And so we are not opposed to like using, you know, dog treats to lure her.
Lure her over.
Yeah.
If you like seeing videos like this, take a look at some of the videos that we have linked right over there. Also, make sure you take a look at our most recent video, which I'm gonna put right over here.
Whether you head this way or you head this way, don't forget to head this way. Subscribe to our channel and click the little bell icon, and that way every single time we find something delicious, you'll be alerted to it.
Till next time, bye.